This is a Garcia Mitchell 300, and I bought it off of eBay and actually paid with shipping under $10 for it. The reason it went so cheap is because the seller was honest, and he said that something was wrong with the bell wire, which it is, obviously. It is stuck. So first thing I'll do is I'll take off the small end, which is the small screw, and I use this tool. This is a tool that if you go to work on a reel, you know, more than once, you really need one of these. But anything that would fit snug and width-wise in there will let you remove it without buggering it up. Yeah, you know, when you take that out, it should remain right on top of the port there, and it's not doing that. So obviously the bell wire is bent. Yeah, you see. So what you need to do in this case is you need to bend it back in place. Just gently bend it around. Till it fits back over there and stays in place. Really, that's all this one needed. But let me go ahead and change the bell spring, excuse me. It's hard to do. I'm doing the camera work, the narrating, and trying to do the work at the same time, so bear with me here, guys. Again, using the same tool. Pretty cool. It's easy to take out. And then lift it up. Oops. And the bell spring just jumped over into my cleaning solution. Wasn't that smart? Anyway, I want to look at it first. That is a new style bell wire for this reel. Somebody has replaced the bell wire in this one, thinking that that was the problem, but it wasn't. Okay. While I've got this open, going to straighten up that trip lever. That is bent pretty bad. That should be perpendicular to the head, and it's not, obviously. I don't know if you can see it or not, but the only thing I'll do is I'll move that over, bend it back into position, which where it's straight up and down like that. Oop, straight up and down like that. Okay, then the next thing I'll do is I'll clean out in here, and I'll clean the bell spring, which doesn't need it too bad, but, and I'll be right back. Okay, the parts are clean, and I want to show you something here. On the one, I actually bought this directly from Pure Fishing, so I know it's never been used. Now you notice the two little bends there, and you notice how close they are together. Okay, on this one out of the reel, they've separated some, and basically that's what happens over the years. Even if it's not used, they will tend to spread out. If it's too spread out, then you've got a weak bell spring and it will not work. But I'm going to put this one back in just to show that normally you don't have to change bell wires, okay? This, if I do it the first time, I'll be lucky. It's not that easy. So first thing you do, you see the little hole there? That fits right into the hole. Like that. And that little nipple helps hold it in place. Then you really need three hands to do this, but I've only got two. Oh, I'll do my best here. You're pushing back the trip lever, you put that little part of the bell spring into that little notch right there, okay? Just like that. And then you turn it until that hits. Now what you have to watch out for here is you have to raise that up just a little bit and then turn it on around until it slides over. Then again, holding it, trying to hold it in place. And I'm an old shaky man, so if I can do this, anybody can do this. As you can see, gee whiz, three hands is always great for this. I have to lay it down. Okay, you position the bell wire over the hole. You get the large bell screw and you replace it. Now there's a little notch in the bottom side of the screw that you might be able to see there, and that has to fit right into the opening. So a lot of times you have to jiggle it around until it goes in. There it went. Okay. And you go ahead, tighten it down. Before you go any further, you look at it and you make sure that it still works. Oops. And yes, it does. It works real good. You have to watch out, make sure that that trip lever is aligned just to fit into that little slot in the bell wire. Just like that. Okay, which it is, so I don't need any adjustment on that. Then you go back to put this back together. Now you just snug these down. Then what you do is you just make sure that it works properly, which it does. Get a little bit of 3-in-1 oil and you put a couple drops in there. Work it a few times. And that's how you service a bell wire or a bell spring.